Welcome to question number 5 in the Principles in Practice question and answer review. I'm Dr. Tony Nettleman, and we'll be talking about public land system. The call of the question. A typical township contains 36 sections. Each section is supposed to measure 1 mile square, so 5280 by 5280. But oftentimes, the township is either smaller or larger than 6 miles square. So we either cannot fit in 36 one-mile sections, or we have too much land where we would have excess property inside the 36 sections. If the township is found to be smaller or larger than normal, along what lines of the township should the excess or deficiency be placed? And you have to select all of them this time, so it could be one or it could be all four. In Figure 2, you're looking at a normal township. We begin at section number 1 on the northeast quarter, and we end at section 36 on the southeast corner. The question here is, if we have more land or less land than a typical township, where should the excess or deficiency be placed? And since this is a select-all question, you could select one of the answers, or you could select 2 or 3 or 4.
Like taking your study materials with you on the go? NLC Test Prep courses are available anytime on any device. Order a bundle today and get access to the most up-to-date, all-inclusive study materials available for the PS exam. Visit us on our website for more information and to sign up today.
Whenever you consider PLSS, you think Survey Bible. And the Survey Bible of the PLSS is the 2009 Manual of Surveying Instruction. Additionally, there should be some other things in your library, including a history of the rectangular survey system, Black's Law Dictionary, and some other great books. I would also pick Elementary Surveying as one of my favorites. So what does our answer choices tell us? If you review the public land system survey instruction manual, it will say that all of the excess or deficiency is placed in the north and the west of the township. Going back to our diagram here, we see that the north line of the township runs 1 through 6, and the west line of the township is 6, 7, 18, 19, 30, and 31. Those are the sections of land which the deficiency or excess will be placed. Understanding the question, where does the excess or deficiency go? The correct answer choices will be A and D, the north and the west of the township. But how is this actually going to work? In a typical township, when we run from section number 5 to 6, or 7 to the closing corner, wherever, you're going to expect to see 40 chains, 20 chains, and then an additional 20 chains. Those are where we put our corners along the west line of the township. So the final 20 chains hits the end of the township on the west line. But if your township is greater than or less than 36 square miles, then you would simply go 40 chains, 20 chains, and then the remainder. And this remainder could be bigger than 20, or it could be smaller than 20. But the important thing to know is all of our excess running east-west goes to the west line, and all of our excess or deficiency running north-south goes to the north line. And if you've got that, you'll be in good shape. Would you like even more great content on the Principles and Practice exam? Please join me at NLCPrep/PS for a full-length, completely up-to-date PS prep course where we go over every major PS topic in gory detail, and we teach you all the essentials you need to know to pass the PS exam on the first try. Join me at NLCPrep.com/PS.